Hello, hello. Hey, Javi. Hey Abby, how you doing? Thanks. Watch the road! X. Okay. Alrighty. That was in search of Boudicca. An ancient British rebel leader against the mother effing Romans. Here's my microphone's way over here. Hello. Anyway, I'm gonna take a little break, and then I'm probably either gonna watch some TikTok tutorials, or depending on what people want to see, if I get requests to write stuff. I'm kind of applying to jobs off camera. Hold on, I gotta stop this. There we go. So no one sees my private information. Because I gots to get out of retail. I got to do something with my life, because I'm right now I'm a 40-year-old bagging groceries, and it's not fun, I'll tell you that much. Anyway, thank you so much for subscribing. Hold on. Can't see the chat right now. See if it... Why am I typing when I have a mic? Good question. I just didn't want to interrupt the documentary. I'm still a little new with the streaming thing. But I prefer to type instead of talking during a show. But I'll talk more if we end up writing or watching some tutorials. But I'm having fun, and I'm just going to take a little breaky break, and I'll be back in 15. Alright. Hold on. See, I got it all ready. I got it all ready. All right, be right back.
determine that the Sasquatchy is real. Well, apparently no one could hear the documentary I was watching, so that's good. So I think the first thing I'm gonna do, once the break is over, I'm going to figure out why no one can hear YouTube. I'm gonna brush my teeth first because I think I have lettuce in there. This is fun. Pardon me. Well, apparently no one could hear the sound coming in from the documentary, so I'm gonna work on that for a little bit. Why couldn't they hear it? What is going on? Oh boy. Don't get tired. We can figure this out.
Alright. Hello, friends. I'm gonna try to fix this audio issue that I have. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put on some tutorials while that's going on. Hopefully the answer will be somewhere in there. Because that would suck if I couldn't play any sound for you guys on the computer. I would cry. I would cry legit tears. I'm crying right now. Does anybody like the sound? Like, comment, subscribe if you like the sound. Hopefully the things will be the things. Hopefully the things will be the things. Okay? Alright, fix this. Okay, I'm gonna turn off the thing while making a sound over here. Yes, I was listening to old TV shows. Alright, Twitch Studio? God, what have I done? Not getting sound from streams on Twitch? You're not alone. Many Twitch users are reporting. Hold on. Okay. So make sure that's working. Many Twitch users are reporting the audio missing issue. This problem can be frustrating, especially when all your other apps have sound. But don't panic. You can fix it. And this post will do it for. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, restart my PC? I don't want to do that. First things to check. Alright. Several different factors can affect the sound on your computer, your auto driver, installed hardware, Windows sound settings. Check the cable net connection.
Yeah, all good in the hood.
Sure your computer's not on mute. Yeah, such a icon. Send me the sound. Okay, now I haven't muted the sound. And is this? Let's see. Maybe I could just do this.
Logged in with your Twitch account, you got this beautiful welcome to Twitch screen. So let's click on the button that says get started. My microphone is being picked up anytime that I talk on this. So if this microphone is the microphone that you want to use, go ahead and click change and shoot all the different things that you may have to your computer. But this is the microphone, so I'm on my cam. So now our web can see me. If you have the webcam plugged in, then kind of this little box down, and then you can shoot your webcam from there. And if you do have it plugged in, then click the front button, and then shoot the button on your webcam. You can use the filters, but I'm going to go ahead and stick with the driver group, which is the default. And you see this little purple button. And now it'll just tell you, they've created a game scene, right scene, and a jack, which is great for now. So it's all the free, you don't have to do any of it yourself. So just see your settings. This is where you can run a test to be able to use your game setup. I'm going to put a video up that shows exactly how to see what your best quality settings are. For your PC and internet specs, but if you can just simply do the run test or run the test you have already. So based off the test it said, I'm going to be able to stream at 1080p 6 frames per second with about 6,000 kills per second, which is very good. So I'll go into the app, and this is where all of me are. So now you can see that we have our gameplay game here, and we have gameplay, so my game will be back here, and then we have this back from the game's not there, we have webcam, and then if I click on this here, we have a back screen. Case I use the bathroom, but I also have a screen right here, you being in focus in the chat box, all that stuff on there. So if we look at the top here, we can see we have a section which basically lets you know how many viewers have PC usage and a couple of other things that are technical. If you look at the top, we got teams, subs, bits, followers, all that stuff on there. So moving past the chat, we have what people are going to do on Twitter. We got our title, we got our name, and we got our that, you got a start button or edit button, the microphone, and this is your desktop game audio. If you're streaming, you're talking, you're going to have the VC meter going up and down, the one is one of your audio systems working. And so I'll set and we'll just quickly read over. So, if you have the VC button, basically,
picking up the motorcycle
outside. That's good. It says, is it picking up?
Test. Yeah. Yeah, it's not picking up the audio here. Wonderful. Okay, I need to figure this out. Add audio. Wait. Yeah. Stop it. Opera. No. Google Chrome. That's right. It's here. Yeah. All right. No. Does that work? Let me ask my mother if it makes any sense.
It's really easier. Moving on to audio messaging, microphone settings, you can match your ball saying, hey, my phone is a bit too hot, but it looks like the upper part is right. I can try my sound like one now more than the stick version on because it's been a great and if you're happy your audio listener that your audio play is off or if whatever reason the webcam you can try to then you go time track. I don't know why that you with theirs and then spice professor gate research. He said this is very easy. It's very easy to do certain things. You put an AI part of this dream can help by clicking keep your key or that key whenever you press that key it'll stream. With different transitional option here, I think the one is a free transition between chats and it's like that's pretty boring. I'm going to do that and that free transition if you ever want you can it's pretty good in motion but like in transition so let's execute now. Let's click in. Wow. Look at that professional. Click in. Play. Oh, yeah. That is lead on the high. That's what you transition. Transition. Video. Anyone? Anyway, go ahead and edit. So let's start with the just adding scenes. I think it'll be nice. And now it's on a screen. So your traditional screen has the text, so everyone's chat is on screen. Is a big bonus. If you want to do this, click on the chat. The bar here, what I'm going to do is add this message, and so we can be there. This is first, I don't like how to do exactly. I'm going to go ahead and put in this corner, and I'm going to stretch it like so. Message there, saying, oh, hold it. So let's turn on the scale. Max. No, now we have our message there. So I ask to see if any message. So I think that's a lot better. One thing I have to do is just see also those alerts. Alerts. And alerts here. I'm going to put it on the scale. Features on, so doing the tag, and once you get here, then the area to come in the middle. Let's say this is enough. Press the button anytime you enter. Pop. Then a nice open. You didn't do that. Okay, so at least my and it had that happened. So, all the things I count on limited box all stuff. I want to look at so then I'm going to check. Really, you can order properly here. The other one is shut top of this. The other chat, drag chat, my webcam. There you can see the fight right back. Basically, the order of operations there. Now, I really want to put this lock apps button in the top left scene because I think it'll be nice. So let's click edit, and now we can see what's on our screen. So the traditional just chatting screen has the text, so everyone's chat messages on the screen, as well as a big blown up webcam view. If we want to do that, we click on the little chat thing that they've already made for us here. What I'm going to do is click add test messages, and just so we can see like how big they are, this don't do this. But what I'm going to do is actually do some stuff wrong. I'm going to click on the webcam here, put it with, I'm going to click on the chat box. Now we have our there, but text messages, and you can see all of that. So that's better. know for the Just Chatting scene is also the alerts. Here's our alert box right here. You can see because I clicked alerts and now we have our box here. I'm going to put it, I don't know, let's say about here. They have a bunch of snapping features on, so if you want to fine-tune it like I'm doing here, then you just click and drag, and then once you got it here, then just use the arrow keys to fine-tune. So I want to have this kind of in the middle. Let's say this is good enough. If I wanted to test like a follow, then I press this button right here. Anytime I get a new follower, it'll pop up right there. So I think everything looks pretty even and nice. Also stretch the open to be freaking huge. If you didn't want to do that, you can really get some pretty good customizations here. So if I get a host, oh god, that's awful. Don't do that. So let's not do that. All right, so I've actually stretched my alert box too large and had that distorted text and the button wasn't working. So this person should add a new layer. So let's click the add new layer button after I've deleted my alerts. From here, you can see all the different things that you can add. You can add countdown, images, text, goals, chat boxes, webcam, all that stuff. I want to add Twitch alerts back, so let's add, and then I'm going to put them under chat. It really doesn't matter, but you can have order operation here because otherwise it looks other. The thing at the top is going to be the other things. If I put chat behind my webcam and I drag the chat behind my webcam, there you go. You can't really see it. But if I drag the chat above my webcam, you can see it. It's basically order operations there, so Twitch alerts should probably be on top. But now what I've realized, if you want to reshape it, click this little lock aspect button at the top left corner, and then now from here we can go ahead and drag like so, and that'll make sure that the text doesn't get distorted. I'm hoping, this is just an assume, I haven't actually tried it yet, but let's go ahead and drag it. There we go. That looks so much better. If we click on follow, this is a great time to look at how we can customize our alerts. So right now we'll click browse, and then you can go to browse again to find an image that you have on your computer, or you can just click on the images tab here and you can find some pre-made ones. So I'm going to do cool cat because cool cat is the best cat. We can change our alert noise, but the default one is this. But if I click change, then we can change it to something else by clicking on sounds. Let's try alert 3 and preview it there. Yeah, that sounds so much better, right? It doesn't matter. When we've done that, you can change the alert duration if you like, but I think this is good so far. I got a follow alert right there, and now I can try follow. And so you basically do that for all of them. So you do that for host, rate, subscription, and you customize it by basically rinsing and repeating the whole process. That's how you add the alert. Just check the screen. Looks fine. Everything looks great. Our be right back screen, maybe customize this a little bit. If I wanted to change the text color, you could either change the text with this here, or you could just go ahead and click on it. Let's say that I want to make the text a little bit bigger. I'm going to go here and change the font size to, let's say, 96. That looks so much better. If I want to change the color, just click this white box, and you can change the color to red. That kind of hurts my eyes. I'll go back to white. So if you wanted to do that, you can feel free to do so. You can change the alignment. You can change basically anything you want to about this text. You can flip it so it's backwards. I don't know why you want to do that. But hey, do it. But the be right back screen doesn't really matter. Just make sure you have your alerts on. And I would personally do the chat thing that we did for just chatting. I honestly like having most of the screen because, hey, you know, the chatters want to see their name. They want to see their messages while you're away. So you might as well help them do that. So we turn the scale up, we dragged it, and then we add messages. So I think this looks good. But doing this, I don't want to move a lot of the stuff as Nigel with the background. I don't want to do that. But let's go ahead and drag the text over to the right, and then we can drag this thing over to the right as well. So this way, it looks a little bit better. I think this looks pretty good for a back screen. Let's go ahead and move on to where I can put the support for most of your sentences. So let's chat really like that. Depending on the gameplay, too, it's going to kind of depend on where you want the chat. And if you want chat on your screen at all for gameplay. Honestly, if I'm playing a game, most of the time I won't have chat on screen, so what you can do is just hide the layer without deleting it, like so. And so if you click this eye, you're like closing the eye so you can't see it. Get it? The webcam, let's go ahead and change the blur. You can go back on edit blur in the top right corner if you want. You can change the size, make it larger, or you can make it larger. I really like it. You see that too often. And you can change the opacity. But the border color, I don't know, let's change it. Something more wacky. That looks okay. Actually, no, that looks hideous, but I'm going to keep it because that's just the person I am. I want to watch the world burn. Now, what you're wondering is, okay, Cody, but how do I get my game captures? So by default, we do have a game capture, and it should capture any full screen application or game that you have. However, if you wanted to specifically capture a game, I'm going to show you how to do that. So let's go ahead and open up a game real quick. So I've gone ahead and opened up everybody's favorite game, Granny 3. Yes, the best game of all time, one might say. So all I did is go Steam, I open the game, and then since Granny 3 is full screen, just go ahead and hold Alt Tab, and then you can switch back into Twitch Studio. So by default, it already captured it, but for reason, if it didn't capture your game, go ahead and click on game capture once again, and then click on edit, this purple button there. Now you can see what is capturing, but it's capturing a full screen application. So if you want a specific window, go ahead and click change. And then from here, you can see all of the different windows that you have up. For instance, if it didn't show up under full screen application, I just go under window, granny 3, click it, and then you can to capture your cursor or similar windows. Or if it's not capturing still, then you can turn on the compatibility and that should fix it as well. And if all of this doesn't work, you can also just do capture screen. So you can choose, I have three monitors, so I can choose monitor 1, I can choose monitor 2, which is what I'm using to record this video, and then I have monitor 3. So really, you can do any of these things. Worst comes to worst, you can use display capture and it'll capture your screen if it doesn't work with the full screen or the window application. It worked for me first time we had issues with it. Now, if you want to, we can hide our chat. Good for the chat. B, be in the corner. Depending on how it is. To clarify, we have both games coming out of this thing right here. Then we have audio, mic, audio, sync here. And then this that video master, and you can add it to the there, as well as your context, and your screen, and all. So if I talk to someone, I don't want to hear the conversation, and I can include mute. And they were hearing the game, then I put in the stream, but now they can't hear anything. And then I don't want them to see me, so I walk in the room, you turn all cams off option, like so, and then now my cams do so. So moving on to the hotkey settings, this is basically where you can make it a little bit easier. You can set if you want to change your volume of how loud it is. You got a nice little bar saying that, hey, my microphone is just on the brink of being too high, but it looks on the upper part is just right. I think it's pretty good. If you're having trouble with your microphone, it sounds like one ear is coming out more than the other, then go ahead and click the convert to mono button, because that's going to take your stereo signal and turn it into one mono signal, so that way it's going to sound balanced on both ears. If you're having some weird audio delays, make sure that your audio delay is turned off, or if for whatever reason your phone is early or your webcam, then you can audio delay, and then you can go ahead and try and time it correctly. I don't know why you have if you do this, and then your microphone press it and press if you would say so. This is basically make life a little bit easier. You can do certain things depending on these guidelines. If you wanted a hotkey to start and end the stream, and you can have one by clicking here, click